I call out of one. I pray this devil die and get every evil thing the Lord got to give. And listen, I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Come, Yahshua. Come, Yahshua. I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Black people on drugs and we suffering and dying. And I know it seems like you can do whatever you want to this people. I know it seems like this, but the time for glorifying yourself is soon at an end.
Oftentimes we come out here and I see that everybody is looking, seeing what we're saying. They're trying to figure out what we're talking about, right? And we understand what's going on, black man. And we talk about the struggle of black America. You understand? We are the only people that's going to tell you about your struggles and how to fix them. You understand? And because we know how to do it, and the answer that we found was right here in the Bible. And you know what we have to do? We have to cry aloud according to the scriptures, okay? Read.
The book of Isaiah. Chapter 58, verse 1. Cry aloud.
Do what?
Cry aloud.
No, sit back in the church pews.
Cry aloud.
No, wait on white angels to come down and save you.
Cry aloud.
No, go ahead and celebrate Christmas.
Cry aloud.
The Bible says we should cry aloud. And that's what we're doing out here on the streets. In ISUPK, upon the command of Jenny Hunter, we go into the highways and the byways and cry aloud. We let you know what the struggles are in black America. We talk about all the atrocities that we face upon the white man, which we call your oppressor. You know why we call him the oppressor? Because he is the one that has his knee on the back of your neck. You understand? Just like who? George Floyd. It is in real life. It's not a fairy tale about how we are destroyed here in Norfolk, Virginia. You understand? This is the real life that we're living here inside of this empire. And the Bible says we should what?
Cry aloud.
Cry aloud, man. Did Caesar Borgia look like he would cry aloud? Caesar Borgia would be whispering, Jesus saves. That's not what we do in the ISUPK. We are here to tell you that, guess what? You should stop smoking weed. You should stop celebrating Christmas. You should stop celebrating Valentine's Day. Stop having abortion. Say out of the goddamn Christian church. That's crying aloud. And you know what that does? That's fix black people, man. That's what they're here to do. We tell you about your transgressions against the laws of God, man. We don't whisper sweet nothings on how you should fix your life. We give you the recipe to get out of the hellhole that we live in so we can rule this empire, man. Take over. We have our own kingdom if we did what we're supposed to do according to the Bible. And guess what we should do?
Cry aloud.
Cry aloud, man. Every priest and prophet of the Lord that has come up here has cried aloud. You understand? They have told you ways on how we can fix our condition. And guess what else we should do?
Spare not.
Do what?
Spare not.
Spare not, man. Spare not. You know what it means to spare not? The Christian church allow you to do every goddamn thing that you want to do, long as you keep dropping that money off in that collection plate. Long as you keep singing them good songs and keep new members coming in too. Long as you keep giving your children over to the minister or to the pastor to be molested. You understand? He's not going to tell you anything or anything that's going to fix your life. But guess who will? The ISUPK will, you understand? We'll tell you the things that you should do, even though you may have your goddamn feelings hurt. But that's the only way real change happens. Sometimes when you put your hand on the goddamn oven, you get burnt. But guess what else you learn while getting burnt? You learn not to put your hand up there on the top of the oven again. You learn that fire is hot, you understand? And guess what else? When we spare not, we can say that, guess what? If you smoke sin, if you smoke weed, it's a sin. If you have an abortion, it's a sin. If you're going into the Christian church, it's a sin. If you love the white man, it's in a sin. It's a bunch of sin. How are you going to love somebody who was made to kill you? That's the truth about real America. While you talking about saluting the flag, he's feeling a way to goddamn do away with you right here in front of your face. Do away with us right here in front of our face. Captain Oz brought out something so heavy. All the money that we give over to the other nation, they should at least say thank you. They should say, you know what? When we go into their stores, they should be on their hands and knees saying thank you.
Right.
But here go the greatest trick of it all, though. If we would live by the law, statutes, and commandments according to the Bible, this empire would fall overnight, man.
Right.
All the police officers that put their children through school, guess what? All that money that we give over to them, it would go into our neighborhoods.
That's right.
It would go to our children. And guess what? We wouldn't be asking for stimulus checks. We wouldn't be asking for handouts. That's why we have to spare not. We have to tell you that the white man is the oppressor that the Bible speaks of, man. He is the devil on the earth, man. He is the deceiver. He has lied to us about every goddamn thing. We don't even know our heritage or where we come from. So that's why we cry aloud, and guess what else we don't do? We spare not. We tell you the truth according to the Bible. You understand? Read on, brother.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
Lift up thy voice like a what?
Trumpet.
What do I sound like? I sound like a trumpet right now. Thank you, brother, man. Thank you, brother, man. Thank you, brother, man. We doing what the preachers won't do. You understand? That's what we're doing. We're waking up the people who the rest of the world has forgotten. The rest of the world has said means nothing. The rest of the world done forgot about Norfolk, Virginia. But guess what? We come out here to wake up the people, man, and tell you that, guess what? We really love you. And therefore, we cry aloud, and we spare not, man. And guess what? We use our voices like a what?
Trumpet.
Like a trumpet. And what is a trumpet? What is a trumpet used to do? A trumpet should be used to warn the people. To let you know, guess what? There's a problem. There's the enemy coming while we're struggling. That's what a trumpet is used for.
That's right.
In war, it is used to give a signal whether to go forward or to retreat. A trumpet. But guess what your Christian pastors are doing? They're using sweet words to you, man.
That's right.
They slide the slick oil right up under your feet. So you like the Fred, you ever seen Fred Flintstones? When they get ready to get in the car, they be pedaling.
Right.
That's what we be doing when you go into the Christian church.
Right.
You do all that goddamn pedaling, and you still in the same spot.
Right.
And ISUPK, brother, we gonna slick up on you and get some traction, man.
Right.
You gonna get some marching orders, right? That's what we gonna do. It's gonna give us the solution that we need to fix our lives, man. So that's why I'm crying aloud.
That's right.
That's why my voice is a trumpet. That's what I use it for. I don't destroy my voice by smoking weed or cigarettes. I use it to wake up the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians to let them know they are the greatest people on the face of the earth, man. Read on, brother.
And show my people their transgression.
Show who?
My people.
My who?
People.
No, the whole world.
My people.
My people, man. Salaki, sir. Oh, so like, come on close to him, brother. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we together, right? You my brother, I'm your brother. Shit. And we showing what our people, their transgressions, man.
That's right.
Nobody else is gonna do it.
That's right.
Look at your what they call him, the choir director. Right. We call he up there playing the tambourine and switching at the same damn time. Talking about he's gonna change, waking up the world, singing songs. We ain't got time for no goddamn song and dance, man.
Right.
I'm using my voice like a trumpet to warn the people.
That's right.
I want your money. I ask you to change your life. Learn who the oppressor is. Be a real brother. Let's find out what real brotherhood and sisterhood is.
Right.
Today in Norfolk, Virginia, I don't know what this is, but I tell you what, it feels right. When I see all the black, Hispanic, and Native Indian people that live around here, it feels like home.
Right.
It feels like somebody I should warn when trouble is coming.
That's right.
That's what it feels like to me. Read on, brother.
In the house of Jacob.
In the house of who?
Jacob.
In the house of who?
Jacob.
His name was changed to what? Israel. Yeshua'Allah, Prince of the Power. That's who you are. That's who we are. We're not African Americans. We're not the so-called Puerto Ricans and all these names that our oppressor has given us. We should go by the name of Israel. That's the name that the Lord gave us, man.
That's right.
Because we are descendants of the greatest people on the face of the earth.
Right.
You should ask yourself, how the hell we end up on cargo slave ships? We should be asking ourselves, how the hell did we end up in the fields picking cotton for somebody who hates us?
Right.
And because we've been disobedient children.
And we play NFL?
And we play NFL football. In basketball for them. We sell records for them. We sell drugs for them. We kill our brothers for them. We make them happy. We are the ones that are making the real sacrifices inside of this empire, and we don't get a damn thing for it. You get more jail time.
Right.
More prison time.
Right.
More deaths. More asking for goddamn vaccines.
Right.
Come on, man. This is the real life, man. And that's why we cry aloud. We spare not. Because nobody else is going to tell you the truth about America. Don't nobody else give a damn about the truth of America. But we do. Because we are the ones that are commissioned to go out and do the work for the Lord upon the command of Junior Hunter.
Trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs. I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues. Call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With